Okay, when I'm straight lining for snapper, I've basically got two different hook rigs that I use, and I'm gonna run you through them both. First, I'm gonna start with my double hook rig, and for that, I use a couple of 7-bar row VMC snapper steelheads. They're good, sturdy, strong hooks, which is what you need when you're in the kelp, when you're really trying to haul them out. And I just need a swivel, and for the leader, I'm gonna go for a bit of 40 pound fluorocarbon. Now this Oshea fluorocarbon, 40 pound when you're fishing in around the kelp, you'd quite often say that's pretty light, but that fluorocarbon for its diameter is so much tougher and it can really handle the abrasions. In years gone by, if I was using normal mono, this would be the equivalent of say using 60 pound or more, this 40 pounds. So I like to use a reasonable amount, say meter and a half. The longer the leader, the more protection you get, but the harder it is to cast. So just remember that, that when you're casting, you don't want your leader too long. Now, I'm gonna take my hooks. Now, slide the first one on, and this is a snood. I leave about 200 mil of tag end, then I take my long end of the leader, and I just start wrapping it around the shaft of the hook. Now it's important you keep those wraps nice and tight and lay them flat against the hook. Now when I've gone around about 10 or 12 times, hold them tight and then I get the end of the leader and I'm just sliding it back up through the hook. So I've not really tied a knot as such, I've just wrapped those twists around and that all pulls nice. And the reason I like the snood is because that hook lays nice and flat. Now that's going to be my top hook. The bottom hook, I just tie a uni knot. Now the key is to get the right distance apart. If you're using a great big long bait, like a really big piper, you might want them quite a way apart. Always shorten the gap up a little bit because you get a little bit of slippage when you tie your uni knot. So, oh yeah, click it. Yeah, you got him, boy. Yeah, you got him. Keep him up, keep his head up. That's the one, bro. That's the biggie. Just get that big dog. Oh, oh no, you're kidding me, man. That was our 20 pounder right there, bruh. So you just tie a uni knot and make sure you have the hooks a little bit closer than you would have, because when they pull up and that uni knot tightens, that gives us our two hooks and we just trim the tag end off. Now, if we're just stray lining in the shallows and there's not a lot of current, I can just tie a swivel onto that and that's my two hook rig. Although there's a couple of variations. Of course, as the current increases and or the depth increases, we can just add ball sinkers onto there. If it's low light, a little bit of lumo tube, particularly if you're stray lining at daybreak or dusk, helps the fish find the bait. But it also has another use. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of luminescent soft tube on here and I'm gonna slide that onto my leader, tie the swivel on. Now, aside from the luminescence, once I bait this rig up, you'll be able to see exactly why I've tied that on. And the swivel, again, just with a uni knot. And of course, if you don't know the uni knot, you can see exactly how that's tied right here at ultimatefishing.tv. And there it is, the snelled or snooted two hook rig with a bit of luminescent tube, 40 pound Oshea fluorocarbon leader, ready to fish. The other leader I use is a single hook rig. So when I'm using a single hook, I use a nice big hook because this allows me to use big baits and it's got a lot of holding power. This is the 9-bar row VMC hook. And for this one, I'm jumping up to 60 pound trace, which would be the equivalent of using 80 pounds. So when you're riding on the rocks, fishing on the rocks or close to the rocks, this is where I jump up to the 60 pound fluorocarbon. And again, about the same length of leader. And this rig, it could not be more simple. Just do a uni knot on the hook end and a uni knot on the swivel. So these are our two basic stray lining hook rigs. And there's quite a few little sneaky variations on how we rig them up with baits. And you can check that out on our very next video right here at ultimatefishing.tv, rigging baits for stray lining.